Let's unbox this Panda Wings. BQ sent me this unit and they asked me for my honest opinion. Some of you might remember I have already tested their Panda Nomi and those cool build plates for the A1. And honestly, they were pretty great. Inside the box, we get a LED strip with its power port, Allen keys and zip ties, the main cable, the adorable ducky, few screws, and the main Panda Breeze units itself, which looks and feels premium. Before installing, I'm running a quick test print, so we will baseline to compare results. I will mark this print with the D for default, without Panda Breeze. After installing, we will run the same test again and compare side by side. Now installation time. First, I wanted to check the weight. This thing is around 395 grams. To install, we need to remove two screws from the printer's X-axis. I also had to remove the Dutch brackets I installed earlier. BQ provides these washer stickers, so I placed them on the board screws holes before mounting the Panda Breeze. The screws provided are slightly longer, which is good. Just attach one each side and the main unit is secure. Easy enough. The Panda Breeze has single cable that connects to small expansion board. This tiny expansion board also powers the LED strip, and the fun fact, the cover of this little board and the part of the motor cover on the Panda Breeze are 3D printed. Let me show you what's inside the small expansion board. Here's a closer look. The expansion board mounts under the X-axis motor cover, where it slots right in. Then connect the Panda Breeze cable to it. From here, the wire expansion board connects directly to a power fan, which is located back to the extruder motor. To do this, we need to remove the back extruder cover by using a scraper. Disconnect the original cooling fan cable. Plug it into a new bypass port. And then connect the Panda Breeze cable where the fans was originally connected. Make sure to handle these tiny connectors gently. Don't press too hard or you could damage something. Snap the cover back on, though it didn't close perfectly flush because of a new wire. Let's see if that becomes an issue. Final step, plug the last cable into the extra slot beside the AMS port and connect it to expansion board. Stick the LED strip under the X-axis and the installation is complete. The axis still moves smoothly, no obstructions. Moment of truth, powering it on. The LED light strip lights up really bright. And there's also a light inside the Breeze itself. Running a fan test from the menu. And wow, it spins super fast at full speed. Time for the second test print with the same filament again. Although small hiccup, during the first attempt when the printer homed and Z-axis moved out, the expansion board came loose and the cable disconnected. I have a top mounted AMS system with the extension parts that become an obstacle. The wire length wasn't quite enough, it got stretched. So I made a small adjustment. I zip tied the expansion board on the top of the X-axis motor instead. which gave the cable more breathing room. The only compromise, I had to remove the LED strip because the wire became too short. But if you don't have an AMS extension mod, you won't face this issue. Anyway, with everything reconnected, the print ran perfectly fine. The test print finish. I marked this as a P, initial of Panda, for the comparison. Side by side, both the default and the Panda Breeze prints look good. But on closer look, the Panda Breeze print definitely handled overhangs better. Even the breezing came out slightly cleaner. I also printed a few other models with the Panda Breeze, and they all came out really nice. Overall, the Panda Breeze does its job well. The design feels premium, and the cooling is definitely stronger. You can literally feel the airflow just standing in front of the printer. That extra cooling really helps with the tricky overhangs and breezing. I also tested it with the PETG parts, and from my observation, the result came out slightly better compared to before. Few things keep in mind. With my top mounted extension mod, the cable length felt a little too short. So if you have a similar setup, be prepared for that. The unit itself weighed around 300 grams. I'm not sure Bamboo Lab recommends 300 grams of weight on X-axis or not, but so far I haven't faced any Z-axis issues yet. Still, it does add a noticeable weight. Another small issue, the back extruder panel doesn't fit perfectly with that extra wire. A few of times while printing, the cap detached. I might redesign that panel myself with a tiny gap for the cable. So that's it. If you own a Bamboo Lab A1 and want a stronger airflow, brighter lights, and of course, a tiny little ducky, the Panda Breeze is a definitely solid accessory. And that's my honest review. Subscribe to 3D World for more 3D printing content like this.